It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go,
take a look in the 5 and 10,
glistening once again
with candy canes and silver lanes aglow.
Fresh balls. I swear to you that I was going to be really festive and put Christmas lights up there behind me, hanging where my Goldblums are, but unfortunately the command hook just ripped right off the wall. So here we have some lights here, and then I've put my Christmas tree all snugly in bed. Anyways, hello and welcome. Today I'm going to be just kind of playing around with some art supplies that I've tried recently and really enjoy. I'm gonna be demoing a little bit of gold leaf application. It's the holidays, it's almost New Year's, it's nice for some gold decor on whatever you may please. Put it on basically anything. You could put it on a structure, you could put it on paper. Today I'm going to be putting it on a mock New Year's card that I made for one of my illustration classes. And I'll talk more about that too. Really, not digging this whole whatever's happening with my bangs. I usually don't wear beanies like over my bangs because it does this thing where it flattens them right down, covers my eyebrows, and that's just not good. But I thought maybe I should look festive, and I don't have a Santa hat, unlike my Goldblums back there. I know I don't upload much, but I thought, hey, it's the holidays, I'll put a little something out there. Plus, hopefully, and I say this every time, I know, I will be uploading more frequently, putting some more art tutorials out there, possibly doing a linoleum cut tutorial, because that's what this was here. So I went out today and bought the gold leaf material. I had some at school that my teacher lent me, but figured I wouldn't steal hers. Purposefully, I didn't go to a specialty art store. I went to Hobby Lobby and got what I needed. It's literally only, well, technically three things. One is the gold leaf. This is it here. It comes in a pack like origami paper. This is about $8, you can see up there. And this is Creative Concepts. They have different types of leaf. They have silver leaf, gold leaf, bronze leaf. I think different types of gold leaf, but this specifically is just a really nice warm gold that I thought I would use today. And the glue that I've got here is Beacon, and the actual name is kind of covered up, but this is obviously also from Hobby Lobby, of $6. So you have your glue, your gold, and then you're gonna get a crappy paintbrush. I recommend, they actually sell some paintbrushes with this gold leaf stuff because the glue will ruin the brush. So like a kid's Crayola painting, you know, the thing that comes with the watercolor. This will do just fine. I think I got this in a pack of like 25 brushes. I just realized that I didn't mention this. I said that I was gonna play with some art supplies in this video, but the things I'm gonna play with are gold leaf on this, gold leaf on a sketchbook page, Posca pens, which is new to me, but I know a lot of people use, which are, you know, sort of a opaque acrylic marker pen. They're really fun to play with. I love them. They get really bold colors. It almost looks like digital work. And then I might do a little sketch demo or something at the end, just for fun. And we'll stick some gold leaf and Posca on it. Open this boy up. Here is the gold leaf unpackaged. And you want to be very careful with this stuff because it will really disintegrate on your sticky, sweaty, grimy baby hands. It has this plastic on here to protect it. Package. I'm gonna open up my glue, and this one, this particular one, comes in nozzle form, but you can get one that is just sort of a screw open top, and you can stick a little paintbrush in it and then paint away. I'm gonna open this up.
Okay, so I'm gonna use it like this. Just, I'm gonna stick my paintbrush in there. Something I recommend now that you're ready to apply your gold leaf is to have some sort of, I guess, warm water, soapy water that you can wash out your brush if you don't want it to get ruined. Because you can get it out, it's not impossible. I don't care about this brush, I'm terrible with my brushes always. So we're just gonna go for it and get this boy all nasty. One thing that I forgot is have a larger brush on hand that you can use to scrub away the excess gold leaf. And I'll show you, it'll make sense soon. Everything will make sense eventually. So what I'm gonna be playing with today is, like I said, this mock New Year's card that I made in my illustration class. And this is a printout. The original is a linoleum block print. It's about yay big. And basically I scanned it, sized it down, and then made a greeting card out of it. And the original greeting card that I turned in had gold leaf here around the outside of the rooster. And then another one I did had it on the inside on the Happy New Year here. But today what I'm gonna do is gold leaf on the outside because it's just kind of a better wow factor seeing all of that gold on the card. So this wax paper comes into play because you can tear it off the sheet, which is originally used for protection of the gold leaf, and it will be used to sort of varnish on top of the gold leaf. Oh my god, count how many times this sticks to my hands. So here we have our glue, and we're gonna dip the brush right in there. You don't want to go too thick because this stuff is not really meant to be chunky. And if you have it on there chunky, it will do some weird stuff to your gold leaf. It will make it stick in certain places and tear up, and it's just generally kind of a mess. When this glue dries, it will be tacky. And that's when it's completely dry. It will be sticky to the touch. So I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I was not very careful about applying this. And it might bleed into the black a little bit. But hey, we'll say that it's messy and purposeful. Art is subjective. It's got a shine to it, and you can see what a horrible job I did there. Now comes the fun part where you really get to see how sticky I am, where you go ahead and you put this gold leaf here. You're just gonna lay it down on top. But this is the fun part where you are literally going to tear away the excess gold leaf that you don't want. And you can kind of peel off the big chunks. But the rest of it, you're gonna do like sort of a scrubbing motion. And you don't have to be very gentle. If you apply the glue correctly, you should be able to be very aggressive with it, and it should scrub away from all the places you did not put the glue. So this is how it looks. It's pretty cool. You can't really get the full effect because I'm just using an iPhone to film this, but it is a really nice, rich, yellow gold on this. Now I've got the fun job of cleaning all of the gold up. It's the worst part of gold leaf. This is uncomfortably close. Yay, time for another new toy, which is my Posca pens. I only have three right now. Here they are. They are really cool, and they sound like a paint pen, because they are. It's really opaque, it's acrylic, and this particular one is 0.9 to 1.3 millimeter. Okay, I use multiple things on this page. This is Faber-Castell non-opaque marker, because you can kind of see, but this is Posca, that's also Faber-Castell, that's Posca. Maybe this isn't the best example to show you guys, because you can't really differentiate between the two.
Okay, I think this is a good page for Posca.
This is all Posca here. Those lighter blue shapes are not Posca, but the rest of it is.
Do you know that I just drew this whole thing and it was not recording the whole time? So we're gonna give him a friend over here that I do record, and sometimes depending on the darkness of the color and what pigment it has, you can layer shapes on top of each other. See, there I just layered it on top of this lighter blue and it goes so easily because it is acrylic. We'll call him the Sunshine Boy since he is yellow. Did kind of a messy job with my application of glue. So these amoebas over here aren't looking too spiffy. But hey, it's all part of the fun. You never really know what you're gonna get. If you're messy like me, I mean. And there we go. Before I finish this video up, I'm gonna shamelessly plug my merch. And by merch, I mean lovely things that you can find on my Etsy store very soon. I'm actually wearing one right now. You can barely see her. I'm gonna pull one out. Little Oni pin. She's new. I just made enamel pins for the first time. She's $10 on my Etsy. There she is. So it will come with a silver butterfly clasp on the back. Right now it just has this on here. And it will come with a little pin backing, and that will be up in my store very soon, probably after Christmas time. This is my newest addition to my shop, which is Waluigi double-sided clear acrylic charm, and it will come on a loop. I haven't gotten a chance to do those yet. I actually just got them yesterday. They are still in the packaging, but I was just so excited about them that I pulled this guy out, and I might stick him on my phone. These will also be $10 on my Etsy very soon. I do not ship internationally. I only ship to the US. That might change eventually, but I'm an idiot, so I need time to figure things out and get the hang of Etsy since I just started a couple weeks ago. As always, I appreciate your total support and your encouragement. I know that you guys have to put up with me not uploading ever, but hopefully that will change. I should go get Suki. Hey, girl. Yes. Yes. Hi, Suki. Say hi. Hello. I'm gonna give you your treat because that's the reason you're here, because you don't come to my room because you hate me. Zooey mama.